my official YouTube channel. Please make sure to go to my website, www.susanmeeling.com, and subscribe to my official YouTube channel. Please and thank you. I'm in the process of getting ready to post on my journal blog, The Ornery PSA. So make sure to go to my website, www.susanmeeling.com, to go and read that journal blog as well as what else I add to that particular area in The Ornery PSA at www.susanmeeling.com. But I am going to go into a few factors of that, so back in the room, I should probably not be that close to the door. This isn't the 1980s, this is the year of 2022, I'm just saying. So, and the door didn't do anything. I know it's an inanimate object. It's okay. See how easy it is for me to make fun of myself? It's like that, y'all. Because there's a song that way. So, I'm gonna make fun of myself in that particular reference.
Which again, The Ornery PSA on my website, www.susanmeeling.com, regarding that journal blog I'll be posting after going, and hopefully the rest of the videos that I have been working on too. This is why I don't like wearing makeup, because I touch my face, and females and males who wear makeup, you understand. Once you put that stuff on your face, and then there's everyday life and like actually going out and doing stuff. So in comparison to this. So this is the 8th of April 2022. And so in this particular official YouTube video, there is the fact that in the 1980s my biological mother was working for Prudential. And in the early 1990s, my biological mother had convinced my biological father to go to college. And I actually took a stand against it. I dealt with the conversations at the time. This is before fifth grade, obviously. So the situations, and you can take this into consideration however you view that when it comes to fifth grade and me taking a stand for my biological father, because he had his certification from the school of blah blah blah, and he had been working as far as his own business, and he had his own business as far as jewelry is concerned for however many years at that point. And so it was one of those, these are not verbatim, but fairly close in those references. Why does he have to go to college? He already has a business. He has his certification to work on Bulova watches, as well as Rolexes and whatever other really expensive watches, because I've seen the commas and the periods regarding the price tags in the store that he goes to. So he already has, a business, and you have a college degree, and you work for a business. He owns a business, so, I dealt with a few things for that. It was as it was, as far as that's concerned. And so, then my biological mother, being as anybody who's met her, and when I say met her, I mean met the real her, not the, let me make some Rice Krispie treats, and here are some snacks, in comparison to who she actually is, in those comparisons. So she had informed me, in front of Mike, no less, that she was going to educate me as to the differences between my having had the certification through the School of Ulva and her having a bachelor's and master's degree in science. And then there was fifth grade. So, you know, I don't know, why did I start working much more diligently to be capable to, like, you know, there are people who, you know, and especially not just in the state of Texas, but I'm very much the people in the state of Texas. No. Mike, he could be a dick. He totally could be a dick. He is a male. But then there's my biological mother and biological sister. And so, yeah. Be careful. You have no idea how bad it is. No. Let me give you an example, okay? So literally, in the middle of situations, she could have whatever in her hand going and do whatever. The phone would ring and then, hello? Oh, that's fantastic. And it's like, I don't know what that terminology is called for whatever that psychological disorder could be. But, like, I'll totally acknowledge I could be, you know, all pissy, murmuring about whatever. I'm not gonna hide that. She will. You'll think that, you know, whatever fluffy cotton candy garbage or whatever, whatever, when it comes to that. So just be careful, because Patricia, my biological sister, is her favorite. She cannot stand how I am. Why do you have to be like your father? Why do you have to be so similar to your father? Well, you know, in this reference, there's the San Antonio Bacon community. There's the San Antonio DFW, as well as Austin area, supposed to be adult consenting lifestyle areas, as well as scuba divers for an overall sort of thing in the state of Texas. Well, you know, I know there are many reasons. I just can't remember all of them, but I do know that there are some. He went to the School of Ulva, and he could work on, you know, Ulva watches and Seiko watches. And I don't mean just like, you know, Seiko, like, you know, the stuff you could go to some regular mass-produced store. No, I'm talking about, like, the types of stores where you have to be buzzed in before you can even actually open the door. And then there's another area that you get buzzed into to then go in there. And then there's usually, for some of the locations, they have, like, some female with, like, this tray that has, you know, some champagne flute or whatever and stuff like that. And so, you know, there's an example. But, you know, my biological mother thinks that, you know, her college degree, you know, the two of them, you know, but she got mad back in the 1980s. So Mike had actually gotten her the job at Prudential. And at Prudential, that Mike had actually got her that job in reference to information technology and the software engineering. Before this point in time in the 1990s, where she was going after him about him getting a college degree compared to his certification. It was one of those, she was complaining, and anybody who's into software engineering mainly, and software design, you have the coding that you have to learn, those updates and stuff like that. And so her certification, whatever renewal rate it has to be, because of the speed that technology goes as far as the coding and all of the different changes, in comparison to scuba diving. Scuba diving, it really just depends on where you start off and then your equipment that you're accustomed to. And yes, in some ways, you know, your lungs are your own equipment as well as your own personal experiences. As far
she had been accustomed to turning the monitor on and then turning the tower on. It's like, I don't know what's wrong with you. That's backwards. You don't ever turn the monitor on before you turn the tower on. Because if you turn the monitor on, and so we argued it was as it was. So when it came to my scuba diving, it was one of those, I'm going to make sure that, you know, there are people who have obviously met five cents and stuff like that, and it's one of those, no. I'm going to make sure that I do this correctly because I know better, you know? So I'm going to do these certifications. There was this, I called it a smorgasbord, and it was 16 certifications, just specialties. And so I'm going to revisit the aspects of in a moment. So back in the 1990s, Mike and Anna were arguing regarding whether or not, because she was pissed off that, surprise, surprise, when it comes to coding and software engineering, that you have to do all these certifications. And so her complaints were, you know, I had to go out to college. I didn't go to college to get a certification. Well, she did that throughout the 1980s. So by the time she's arguing with Mike about how she felt that he should go and get a college degree, is one of those, why, yet again, he has a business and you're you. You work for a business. Hey, that's cool that you work for a big business such as Prudential, but he has his own business. It's literally a specialty. What he does, it's completely different than what you do. His stuff isn't ever going to change. Your stuff is literally changing by the day. That's why you have to get certifications every so often, because of the way the coding stuff is, to make sure it's legitimate what you're doing, because you have to do it on an even keel and all this sort of stuff. And you know, of course, who was actually doing the work compared to going to a class and stuff like that? And it's like, all right, well, you know, maybe I, and then I even brought it up, well, maybe I should go to these classes too. And she was like, no, you don't need to. No, I think I should. No, you don't need to. They don't need to meet you. They know it. Well, you know, I was already meeting with who I was meeting with back then. And I don't mean in the backyard portions. I mean in regards to Asher Holmes Elementary School. So, similarly, regarding my son, as far as, you know, here's this group, I know exactly, not exactly per detail, but I know that meeting with, you know, the group that I've not arranged him to be in, you know, there will be, and I warned him, there will be people that want to speak with you. Be careful. You better tell the truth at all times. Better be honest, because that's important. You know, the military that honesty, because it is important, okay? And so I grew up in Asher Holmes Elementary School, but more specifically, the state of New Jersey, which is a blue state or a Democrat state for the majority in the area of where we were after we wound up in Washington State after the Stoney LaRue concert in March of 2013 at Cowboys Dance Hall. Isn't it an irony? Referencing when COVID began in March of 2020. Maybe that's just a coinky dink that I've noticed. So anyway, back in the 1980s, she was complaining because, you know, after, I think it was 1985 was when they started making it mandatory that if you're doing information technology and you're actually doing coding, you have to have these certification updates because of the way the, it wasn't just HTML, there were, depending
however many years in college, and it was one of those, yeah, but that's the thing. You went to college for your master's and your bachelor's in reference to science. It's not technology. That's not how that goes. So your certifications are in a completely different field than your degree is. And her thing was, well, it's the exact same. No, it's not. Not in the slightest. I mean, there is a science to technology, but it's not the science that you studied. It makes perfect sense. Well, then she started pushing on Mike, oh, go and get your college degree instead, which is an irony because she wanted him to become a nurse, which is in a scientific field. And it's like, don't do it. No. No. And so she essentially, here's the thing, though, because I remember she had taken my biological sister and I to go see one of her friends as far as Prudential was concerned, and the females were talking about how Anna, at that point in time, was doing what she could to
And so what's on your mind? Oh, my schmoly has a bitty on your feet.
Yeah, well, it's a bit different. It's a computer. Oh, well, a computer, a video, whatever. You know, schmoly, it's just my last family.
Talk to you later, have a go, da da da.
Yes, this is Yenta, and this is Yeti.
Mm-hmm.
And so... discussion when I was in Ashland Homes Elementary School. I think it was in third grade at the time. Military regalia in his office, and it's like, I don't know what to do, the equivalent of, I can do this, but in a very different capacity, where it's like, yeah, no, an old time Presbyterian church, you know, was used as a hospital during the Revolutionary War, General George Washington's private offices out back, da da da, Battle of Monmouth isn't far off to the side. If you look at General George Washington's office, it's like the equivalent of 10, maybe 11 o'clock, depending on where you're actually standing in comparison. It's actually quite ideal where his office is when you take into consideration where the Battle of Monmouth was, and so on and so forth. And Sensei Ba was just like, well, you tell me some more. And so, you know, as one of those, he had all these military regalia stuff, and he had these shiny things. It's like, are those ornaments like for a Christmas tree? Because, you know, I'm just, you know, in my defense, I was in eighth grade and I was 12 years old at the time, and Pastor McKenzie didn't walk around in his military uniform, you know, at church. So it was like, oh, well, look, are they like, you know, because it had a wooden box and stuff like that for certain things. Are they like ornaments for a Christmas tree? They're shiny like they are. I can do this.
So I go back and make fun of myself.
Look what I can do. But you know, it's one of those. I want to do the competition circuit thing for. I only want to go one go round as far as that's concerned and see where I'm at. It's kind of more of a self evaluation sort of thing. And realizing that in the Taekwondo studio, that was, you know, not in any offense to anybody there. It's more along the lines of I need to make sure that I'm capable for certain things. People, those who knew about me talking about my nightmare from second grade, you know, the ones that actually did believe me back then, you know, like Joe Jose as far as the director of security, and then all those other, you know, whatever names regarding the World Trade Center. And the World Trade Center Plaza is one of those. Okay, well, you know, he understood. He took me seriously, especially when it came to the 1993 situation. He had already taken me seriously as far as my nightmare. And then the 1993 situation happened. And I remember this specifically because even though I had mono Epstein-Barr bronchitis, Lyme disease, and the flu all at the same time, you know, I was. Sometime shortly thereafter, and Mike had answered the phone, and he was like, you know, he explained to Joe Jose, he's like, no, she's sick right now. Which the irony of ironies, if you were to think back to then, you'd be like, he'd be capable to know that I went and did as I did, and as far as running around and assisting with security stuff, as far as certain
You know, then there's 2001. And so, you know, not making light of that at all, but it is what it is. There is the irony of ironies and comparison. But if I hadn't been sick at the time, it would have been just as simple as me. Most likely, it would have been a similar situation, just not in a medical setting, as far as that's concerned. But anyway, so...
There's a lot, but seriously, not, you know, in the hypothetical as to whatever could be proven. And so, just saying. So, how it went was essentially, you know, let me go prepare. And so the circuit back then was you had to place in the top 3 to 5. But you had to do it in 2. So you had to, so, you know, up to the as far as like each competition, you had to be at the very least the top 5. But, you know, the higher you placed in the top 3 automatically guaranteed your slot in regards to going up for the next competition. And so, but you had to get both. You had to get sparring and you know, not being mean in that capacity. It's more along the lines of, but I still got first place in the United States of America. So, not to be rude or anything, you know, I'm a little, you know. Maybe it makes sense now why I'm so protective in other capacities, but, you know, it was as it was. And, you know, but that was when I was 12 years old. That's all. And so then, at that point in time, between the international Taekwondo competition, as well as having met Governor Christine Todd Whitman, because of my ocean poster, as far as cleaning up the ocean, and then my background as far as biological mother, biological father, if they knew about my grandpa Gawit, that they would have had to, I would guesstimate, and then my buckthong and my buckthoo, as a marine science and technology school with the Navy attachments, like, come on, it's like, yeah, that's gonna be great, I know, I'm gonna be tasty, I got there, well, you know, Patricia, I don't know, she didn't even want to do it, it's one of those places that's getting attached, and, you know, those who understand that, and so went through the equivalent of ASVAB back then, and this is all before graduating eighth grade, by the way, this is before eighth grade graduation, which that is an important factor to take into consideration. And then there's the essay formats, because then you also had the interview processes, like three interviews. And so then my biological mother's like, no, you could just go to public school. Just go to Marlboro High School. But MAST is a charter school. It'll, you know, but I don't want to pay for your uniform. But you don't actually have to in comparison. So instead, you know, after a couple of days at Marlboro High School, then I was sent to St. John Vianney High School instead. Because, you know, St. John Vianney High School, in comparison to MAST, you know, where the charter school, the only thing that had to be paid for were my PT uniforms and then my school uniforms for a military-associated academy. Okay. Instead, college degree. Master's college degree, mind you. Instead of going to the charter school, where the only thing that didn't have to pay for books, didn't have to pay for any extracurricular activities unless there were, you know, possibly like if it was a field trip type. No, she wanted where I went to St. John Vianney High School, you know, just a parochial Catholic high school. In New Jersey, remember those prices? Yeah, had to pay for the bus route because it's not a public high school, so you got to pay for that too. Then the uniforms and any extracurricular activities. Well, could have gone to the, you know, the intelligent route, you know, in my opinion. But you know, whatever. I don't know what would marine and science technology school, you know, just so happen to be after Sensei Bob. Certifications, you know, how could that be common sense to see? But Anna, similarly regarding to Anna and Mike, as far as the, oh, well, you know, look, I'm working at a job where I have to go and get certified over and over again, but your certification, you don't have to get recertified. It's a situation difference between technology and watches, though. She didn't want to pay attention to that common sense sort of thing. It's like, it's not difficult. It's really not. It's not rocket science. It's not difficult. I don't understand, but whatever, right? You're going to learn at some point, possibly, I don't know. And then, you know, Patricia, look what I can do. I can do this and I can do this. Great. One day, which is funny, I was
doesn't win because those who have met my biological sister knows how that is. And so, she did it, and I'm just in the shoes at the same time. Just so on and so forth, just stop. He's obviously capable to get this stuff done and all this whatever. And so then as far as the St. John Vianney High School thing, it was this huge argument because it's like, I could be in MAST. And instead she's like, St. John Vianney High School is the same thing. Why would you say that St. John Vianney High School is the same thing as Marine and Science Technology School with the Navy?
Because I saw the uniform.
What does the uniforms have anything to do with that?
Well, they have gray PD uniforms.
Uh-huh.
And then they have other gray uniforms.
You mean the version of Class A's?
Yes. At St. John Vianney High School?
There's nothing similar in anything.
Well, you know what else? The shirt is maroon.
What does that have anything to do with anything?
Well, I saw their uniform and they have a maroon ribbon.
So do you go to college to get stupid?
Which then, well...
as far as that was concerned.
But you know, that's what it is. So later, when I got to Carrollton, as far as I was concerned, it's like, hurry. I should clarify. So I had gone down to the Gulf of Mexico area. I think it's South Padre Island. My son, my daughter, my children's biological father at the time, or dead ex-husband now, but whatever, as far as that's concerned. Time, he was alive, and it was before the first separation. I had this, I can't remember what it was. I had gotten the newspaper, I do remember that, and I was reading the newspaper, the San Antonio Express News, and I cannot remember what the news article was. It had absolutely nothing to do with the ocean, but I had read, there was a paragraph of the ocean. And, you know, well, there's the Gulf of Mexico. Well, that's a gulf. That's not the ocean. Because it's the truth. And so, went down there. You know, James and Lydia had fun. They were, I think they were about 2 and 3 years old at the time. And so, certain point, you know, it was evening hours, essentially, and I'm like, all right, and you two, you stay right here, and they're just like, yeah, I can't, you know, then whatever, and it's like, I'm gonna go swimming for a moment, and so my daughter was just like, oh, yeah, because they were toddlers at the time, and looked at, this for a moment, okay? And they're like, yeah, you two are far more responsible.
possible as toddlers. And so... For those who know how those film pictures came out, in regards of the swirls of light and stuff. And so, you know, it just is what it is. So, went and took care of the stuff. It was just as it was. And then I got into scuba diving and, you know, earned my 26 scuba diving certifications because I figured, even though so let me back up real quick. So I went into Scuba Toys, and the guy was like, oh, whose account do you want to be on? And let me also clarify, when he said the way he said it, in my thoughts, I heard, and one, two, for those who know Sesame Place. As far as that, I can't remember. Just something about his accent. I couldn't put my finger on it at the time. I was like, three, But no, it's my own account. Thank you very much. In my thoughts in regards to him. Specialties that you can earn after you get, you know, whatever certification as far as that's concerned, because there were the different levels, and I was like, well, I'll go with National Geographic Open Water, that means more education, and I know that I'll be capable to transition that, whether on land or in the water, or, you know, just aeronautically, it's automatic, and so, you know, looked at the 16 certifications, and it's like, yeah, I'll complete earning each one of these. And she was like, we've had a lot of people come in and say that. And what usually happens is instead of completing all
going to earn my National Geographic Open Waters. Let me tell you what is going to happen. I'm going to earn my National Geographic Open Water Scuba Diving Certification. I am then going to earn each and every one of those smorgasbord of 16 scuba diving specialty certifications. And then I'll go scuba diving in the ocean.
Maybe. And she had brought up, well, there's two that, you know, you need to be in the ocean.
Well, then I guess I'll put those two last. And then I will go and take care of what I gotta go take care of, because I was already planning my son, my daughter, and niece, essentially, at a point, as far as the family vacation out to Florida. And so that I had to do my work, because I'm that type of person. I take certain things extremely seriously when it comes to preciseness. So I have to do things a certain way, especially when it comes to scuba diving, in comparison, because to what I needed to take care of. And so went over the details and stuff like that, and I earned them, and it became kind of, even though I was doing volunteer work at International Scuba, it was kind of, oh, well, what certification do you want to earn today? And it's like, that one, because I need to get that taken care of for my work. And so it went the way it did, as far as that was, as it was. And, I had told my biological mother that I had gotten into scuba diving. And, I wanted to go to Hawaii to go take this. And your father was like, well, I've already been there. It's like, well, yeah.
Is on your hands by your choice. Keep that in mind. I will always have a clear conscience because you will make whatever choice you
my hands will always be clean. Permanently. Remember that. And
my biological mother didn't like that because she tried
doing what she did when I was growing up as a child and a teenager.
As one of those,
that's the facts. So I've warned people repeatedly. I haven't ever played any games because I don't like games. And so my biological mother had, at a point in time, just before the cafeteria table situation, but after the tree TP situation, and Mike was at work, similar to 2002, and Anna got in my face and did as she did, and she tried using Patricia as leverage. I was one of those, no. I will not. You will deal with this, and you will accept it. She went on her whatever, whatever, and I said, I will not. Because it was already as far as my graduation. She already knew that I was going to graduate St. John Vianney High School early. So that was part of the move to Illinois last minute. She knew about all that because she had been to college. She knows about the transfer situations as far as classes in 1998. So again, where I could have graduated an entire year early, she had her temper tantrums as a spoiled brat, and it was as it was. And so it was, no, I'm going to do things because whether you wish or not to accept it, I don't care. You will only cause me to be cold to you. Colder. Make your choice wisely, because I will always be capable to sleep at night. You, on the other hand, I cannot say the same thing for you. Accept that. And so, people didn't understand in New Jersey how bad it was, or New York or Pennsylvania. People in Illinois had no idea when it came to that, because when we moved to Illinois, I refused to have anything to do with coding. And I warned her of that, because that was part of her issues, was that if I had gone to MAST, legally, she knew, as far as MAST, that I'd be directly associated with the Navy, Marine Corps, Coast Guard, Air Force, and Army, like that. She had her issues, because Grandpa Gavitt, and how she couldn't ever get any information from Grandpa Gavitt, because he told her one thing one time, and similar to the way Patricia was, oh my God, it's not them! Same thing. And he didn't even give her anything big on that. He gave her something so small and everybody knew. Because she just couldn't keep her damn mouth shut. Because realistically, typical type. And then she threw a titty baby temper tantrum because he wouldn't sign the paperwork that would give her the recommendation to be in officer school for the Air Force. He fully refused her to go. If she hasn't told anybody that, as far as, I don't know, but Grandpa Gavitt, this is whatever, as far as whatever, she brought him paperwork as far as college and all this sort of stuff, and he refused. Did not care.
It's because of who you actually are. The Air Force does not need, want, or desire your type of people. Has enough stuff going on. Stay out of it.
And so she had gotten caught forging his signature. He called her out on it. He contacted his guys. His guys went. She was just about to go. Pulled her back. I was like, nope. You are not going to Air Force Officer Academy School. Because you are not good enough. You want to go in the Air Force? You go enlisted. Well, she thought she was better than going enlisted. Because she didn't want to earn her way up. She didn't want to do the actual work it took. He even told her she could go enlisted and then earn OCS, or whatever the equivalent is, if that's the same thing regarding the Army. And her temper, to anybody who's dealt with that, you know exactly how that went, but she was younger at those times. So she blamed Grandpa Gavin, because Grandpa Gavin would not sign her to go in. At all, because of her intentions, because of what she had already done. How many times it had been proven over and over again what her actual intentions were. My childhood, my teenage years, my biological adult years, even to this point in time, my biological maternal Aunt Edie, Aunt Chris, Uncle Leonard, and Uncle Neil can go into details. Neil, in that specific, wouldn't have had to deal with what he dealt with, because it was because of Anna that he got addicted to those aspects. And she did that in front of Grandpa Gavin. Let him know, look, here you go. That was her as it was sort of thing. She didn't care in any capacity, because they were Grandpa Gavin's children. Not, you know, people who have done the step-parenting thing. Yeah, yeah, bye, bye, whatever, whatever, whatever. So, you know, as a child, when, which is an irony in regards of my journal blog that I'm going to be posting soon. My Grandpa Gavin was involved with the United States of America's Armed Forces officially since World War I. And a pigtails and stuff like that. And all of these guys went, you're a child. What are you doing here?
Oh, you hear me, Grandpa?
Yeah, he's a grandpa now. Yeah, whatever it was. And Grandpa got, had to. Yeah, come on in, fellas. One guy actually did that. He's like, you're a child. Yeah.
I'm gonna grow up one day, though. I'm gonna grow up, I'm gonna be Phoenix Charles.
I don't remember if he was on the oxygen tank just yet, actually. I know he was having certain things. I think he might have had an inhaler by that point. But anyway, so this one. Grandpa Gavin goes and tells one of these guys, he goes, go see what you can do as far as her. And the guy was like, what do you mean? And he's this big, burly guy. Big old and he's just like, you, come here.
To my face, and he's, essentially not nose to nose with me, but pretty close. And so my eyes got all cross-eyed because I couldn't. And he's like, what are you doing? And I'm like, I was
doing, I could, but she kept getting closer. What are you doing? He's like, oh no,
it's a girl right there, get it. Something, I can't remember the exact words or whatever. And like,
I could go and catch it and get off.
And he's like, aren't you scared of me?
Why?
He's like, rawr, whatever, whatever. And I'm just like,
aww.
He's like, are you making fun of me?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's essentially what happened. So, yeah.
So,
right before.
So, he gets down and he's like,
you're just, you're a little girl, you think you can ride, whatever the words were. Freaked out. I won't let go.
Guys, yeah! compared to me. Oh, yeah, 4 or 5 years old and stuff like that at the time. And so I'm like,
this is what you do!
Grab his arms because he's all flailing around. And he's like, wait. So he goes to stand up, and I'm literally just dangling because this guy is huge. And so then I go and wrap my legs around, like, the, you know, if I were to scale it down. So, like, it's like, go wrap my legs, like, the equivalent around right here compared to, like, the size. And he's like, and grip on Gabby, and he was just like, yep, just go sit down. Soak it in. She's just that way.
He's got the other guys who are like, what do we do? What do we do? We're ready, Gabby. What's going on? I've got it.
It's okay.
Gabbett! actually sat down in the chair, I'd go and gymnastic sort of thing, climb around, like, think kind of swing dance a little bit. I let go real quick of his neck, swing around to his back and grab around it. I'm like, piggyback ride!
Official test and stuff like that. And Mike was like, so you're allowed to earn one more belt. And that's it. Because you are not allowed to earn your black belt. After what I saw at the competition. And so I took that as, why not allowed? Well, because then you have to register your hands. What does that mean? Why would I have to register my hands? To register my hands. He's like, because there's a law. So you already, you know, but by that time, I was like, but I didn't get first place, so what does that matter? He's like, it matters a lot because you earn second and third. Yeah, but I didn't earn first place, as you brought up. Yeah, but you don't need to be a black belt, because if you're a black belt, you have to register. Oh, the red belt! And so, you know, that sort of stuff. So instead I have black boots, but they're not the same, obviously.
Yeah, I know, because I didn't earn my black belt.
Sorry, but that was back when I was 12 years old anyway. So, you know, that was so many years ago. That was 1996. So, you know. After the other, and then it's one of those. So when it came as far as Mike was concerned, you know, your mother says it's, yeah, she's stupid. Da, 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 da. You're gonna I'll give her the respect that she earns. I'll do that, but that's about it, right? And well, you know, you should. And we were in the basement at the time, and so the basement in Illinois. Okay, so let me go into that. So you go down the stairs from the kind of third-ish level. Walk in from the front porch where the garage is on the side. There was, at the time we moved in, this speckled mirror, two doors kind of sliding thing of above, which was the closet, or a coat closet. And then there was this kind of brick-ish looking linoleum. To the left was the great room-ish area, which wrapped around to the dining room area, which went into the kitchen area. So after, and then I came back to that area to go out the front door, and then there were two sets of stairs. One set of stairs went downstairs, one set of stairs went upstairs. Upstairs was a full bathroom, my bedroom, then the master bedroom, as far as, you know, because of that, by size, technically only, because a master bedroom actually has the bathroom in it, in my opinion, when it comes to a house. And then the other bedroom where Patricia's room was. We went down the stairs, which were actually the first set of stairs, in comparison to the second set of stairs. It was kind of a den area. That's where the computer was kept, and the TV and couch, and then there was another room, and then the bathroom area, but also the stairs to the basement. So in the basement, when you walk down the stairs, there was this built-in bar. To the left, as soon as you came in, to the right, there was a sink, washer, dryer, refrigerator, freezer, and then it led you out to the garage area. But if you stayed where the bar area was, you could tell where, like, I swore that house was either a swinger house because of some of the stuff the back wall was naked Romanesque women. As like, this had to have been, I recognize. Sure, we moved out of New Jersey. Mm-hmm. I know that sort of stuff. So one wall was kind of made out of like cork-ish sort of material and stuff, and another one was kind of wood, and they had it had built-in spinning green stools.
As far as the back
area. And so we were down there. There's a hole in the wall on the side to go into the washer area. That would be from when I, around this point in time, where I was like, I don't know why you can't just let me go along. I'll go do this. I got to sing. Blah, 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 blah. You know, I was 17 years old at the time. Blah, 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 blah. So then, you know, Mike's like, give me a
a valid argument as to what makes you think that you can handle the army.
Well, you know, I grew up being raised by you.
Just go to college.
I did not bring up that he did not get his RN.
I had that intelligence.
Knew better than to say that back then in the year of 1999.
Well, no, that was in the year of 2000. I think that was January. And so, maybe February at the latest. And here's this, what would make you think you're good enough, da 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 da. What would be the benefit that you could actually give to me?
Well, you don't have to pay for my college. You don't have to pay for my housing. You don't have to pay for my food. You don't have to pay for my books. I get educated in whatever specialties that would be needed. I have room and board, I have food as far as all that's concerned, and I get health care.
What he did. Or, well, he went.
says to him,
oh, so I don't have to pay for your college?
Nope.
I don't have to pay for your books?
Nope.
Then you'll have a housing location that you'll live in?
Yes.
And you'll get 3 squares?
Yes.
And you'll get health care?
Yes.
And your college will be paid for?
If I go to college. I'm going to stay and enlist because I don't want to deal with politics. And I know that once you get to a certain rank enlisted, the only reason to go to college is if I want to be an officer first round. And unless I get field grade promoted, I don't want to deal with those aspects.
Because it's
absolutely mandatory.
And they pay for it?
Technically.
Well, let me get you a cigarette.
Will you sign the paperwork for me to go? It got from the time of my official graduation, 3 months retro. Will you sign the paperwork for me to go? Because I don't want to waste my time. I'm not going to do things you wish I would. You have Patricia for that. Leave me alone.
Anna would cry and all that garbage. And only at the time of November did she try to be like, oh, but you're my daughter.
B.S.
You haven't ever considered me your daughter. So don't start now. And that was as it was. She started crying and all that. And oh, you don't get to all this other garbage of garbage in that reference. Not playing with you. Can I have the paperwork signed? Will you sign the paperwork? Will you sign the paperwork? Can you sign the paperwork? Will you sign the paperwork now? Will you sign the paperwork now? What about signing the paperwork now?
It took until the 6th of March because Anna held out until then. And it's like, finally, I can go.
Just leave me alone. Fuck. Like, seriously.
And so she did all this other garbage. Well, when I went to asthma at the MEP station that following weekend, her and Mike signed the paperwork. And that was Anna. Anna was the one who held out. I was like, let it go. You're not going to get me. I don't want you. I have stuff to do. You are literally putting the nation at risk. Stop. You are so selfish. Well, I sounded like Grandpa Gavin. So she started crying and all that stuff. Well, when it came to whatever the week was in reference to the 6th of March, fine. I think it was the 3rd. She finally acknowledged it. Okay, we'll sign the. I brought the paperwork. I don't want you to hear. I want to take your father so that way we can go to the recruiter station. So that way, whatever, so that way we can talk to the recruiter and blah, blah, blah. So they scheduled, or Anna.
so I guess, I don't know, whatever she thought was gonna be what it was gonna be. The recruiter station was pissed because it was Anna who had been the waste of flesh and waste of time the entire time. Mike, once he got the information that everything was gonna be taken care of, but Anna was the problem. As like, you know, Grandpa Gavin, I hope, like, you know, you know what Grandpa Gavin would do to you. You're just bitter because he wouldn't allow you to, because even you have to acknowledge the fact that you're just not good enough. Just accept it. And, I mean, my biological aunt, Edie, her two daughters, Kate and Allie, mainly Al, Kate, I told her what was going on, and she's just like, this is ridiculous. Your mom's a twat bitch. That is such kind words. And so, like, it was ridiculous. I don't know. It was what it was. And so, was as it was. So, that weekend, following the 6th of March, recruiters were like, all right, we're going to go up to Chicago and stuff like that. The entire recruiter station, by the way, from whatever time in November, maybe December, through to that point, I've been doing the depth program the whole time, every chance I could. So, when they did PT runs, I was there. When they went to whatever, whatever, I was there. And went and did whatever. The three different branches that were there was the Army, I think it was the Navy. I know the Marines. And it might have been the Air Force. I know there is the difference. I obviously know the difference. But yeah, like, so those guys were all, they were in, I wasn't even going into the other two branches, and those recruiter station guys were pissed off at Anna. Like, it was to that level, because my recruiter station area, as far as the Army, had informed them as far as mass. The Marines were like, I can't believe you got invited to mass. Like, they had gone and checked into it, and they were like, yeah, I saw your ASVAB scores. Hey, girl. I was like, yeah, sort of thing, because I had got a 93. And so, on the ASVAB back in 1996. And that didn't include the essay portions. So then it was what it was. So then I went off to the MEP station that following weekend with the guys and got everything taken care of, signed everything, because it was one after the other. I have been waiting to go literally since 1996 at that point in time. And so I get back and I'm ecstatic. I'm like, hey, who wants to celebrate? I'm going to go handle business. And instead, oh, you're coming to mass and it's, you know, whatever. And you're
Do you really hate your life that much? That you have to be that type? Like, can you be miserable at, like, another point in time and stuff? Like,
just, and then Patricia, oh, you're celebrating leaving, and
I'm celebrating life. Seriously.
Get over yourself. And so, I didn't pick the date for me to ship out. That was generated by the computer. Because that's how it was done. Not the whole thing, but
MIT, which, you know, she also tried to claim that I was in charge of somehow in comparison to the facts. As to how that goes. And so it would be funny though if the computer was like, well, since you did that, you know, because, you know, in that reference. But yeah, no, at the ASVAB station, they didn't really hesitate when it came to me. I mean, the irony, just as similar to MAST with the Navy attached, but they were like, no, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Always Anna being a waste of time. She wanted everybody else's attention. She wanted people to do this and do that. And it's like, it is not about you. It has not ever been about you.
This is what you taught Patricia. And this is the problem with that. Get out of the way. Accept it.
You could have actually had a happier actually been capable to celebrate stuff, but because of how bitter, how low you are, and all that stuff, just accept the fact that you are not
in the process.
Get out of the way. And, you know, there were several times where she complained, oh, I swear I can hear Grandma Gavin. Well, you know what, it's not my fault. He likes me better than you
when I was a child.
Or, it's not my fault that he liked me better than you as a teenager.
Which then she started crying.
He was my daughter.
He's not. You know how many times you told him he wasn't your dad? Well, that didn't go over. Stop playing.
Can't stand games. Because the irony of irony is when I was doing my work as far as some of the stuff back in the late, especially 1980s into the 1990s, she was playing stupid-ass computer games.
While I'm doing the work, she's being dumb.
Just dumb. And the regulations as far as stuff, it's like, get out of my way.
Just go. And so it was as it was.
And so it's one of those, I made attempts to explain to people, and instead they wanted to, you know, especially depending on the year,
wanted to pretend that they knew better. And it's like,
you know what, you're repeating words that Anna has used. I don't trust you. Use those words with me when it comes to things, that's automatic. I don't trust you. Because I've dealt with that. And I called very few people out of that. Who's Anna? And it's like, So, you know, it was one of those, had the irony of
not only my journal blog, the Ornery PSA, on my website, www.susanmeeling.com. That'll be posting soon. There are the aspects of another official YouTube video that hopefully will actually upload, so that way I can actually put it on my website and stuff like that, because of the facts regarding how Edward Snowden should be fully exonerated and be given a presidential pardon, in my opinion. And people, as far as, especially in the civilian sector, in those particular references, Edward Snowden is correct as far as accountability and responsibility, as far as civil and legal actions against those that had done certain things in comparison, and some of the guys, as far as the names he had brought forward, you know, that have been dealing with similar aspects as far as, in my opinion, should get a presidential pardon, an apology,
actually attention to detail, in my opinion. But subscribe to my official YouTube channel. I kind of figured that was common sense in regards to